Coming up in this video, you will learn the right way to duplicate pages in WordPress when using the Beaver Builder Page Builder plugin.
Hey there, I'm Jennifer Franklin with Beaver Builder, and on this channel, we share with you tips on how to use Beaver Builder to build WordPress websites in minutes, not months. If you're new here, consider subscribing and ring the bell to get notified of upcoming videos.
Duplicating a page built with Beaver Builder is pretty easy, but the way to do it is somewhat hidden. For example, let's say you want to use the layout from this page to create another page just like it within your WordPress website. In this video, I will show you how you can duplicate the page from the Beaver Builder Tools menu. But first, I have a few quick tips before we dive in. First, do not use duplicator plugins to duplicate pages with Beaver Builder layouts. There are a number of plugins available on the WordPress plugins repository that can duplicate a page. However, Beaver Builder has a built-in method to duplicate a page that I am going to show you in this video. And it is recommended that you use this method only to make sure that you do not end up breaking your pages. The second tip is that the Beaver Builder layout must have been either published or saved before you can duplicate the layout. If you make editing changes to the layout after you open the page and then duplicate it before saving the page, the duplicated page will not show the changes, and the changes may be lost on your source page as well. To save your page as a draft or publish your page, simply click on Done in the upper right-hand corner. Next, you'll either click on Save Draft to save your changes without publishing them, or click on Publish to make your changes visible on the front end of your website. Now that we've covered a few getting started tips, here's how you can duplicate any Beaver Builder layout to a new page with the same layout and metadata. This works for standard Beaver Builder layouts, themer layouts, and several saved items such as layout templates, rows, columns, and modules. First, let's open the page that you want to duplicate in Beaver Builder. From the front end of your website, you can simply click on the Beaver Builder link in the WordPress admin bar. You should see the Beaver Builder logo in the upper left-hand corner with the name of the page that you are editing. Go ahead and click on the arrow in the upper left-hand side of the WordPress admin bar to open up the Tools menu. Next, on the Tools menu, click Duplicate Layout. A new page will open up in the WordPress editor. Here, you will notice that the new page is named Copy of, and then the name of your previous page. So in this example, my page was sample page, and my new page is copy of sample page. Let's go ahead and rename our page title. We're going to call this page Awesome Page. Next, you will also need to rename the URL slug for this new awesome page. By default, the URL will be duplicated with the word copy at the end. My sample page became sample page copy, as you can see in this example. To change the slug, let's go to the permalink section, which is found in the settings on the right-hand side of the page. If you don't see the permalink option on the right-hand side, click on the gear icon, which is located to the right of the Publish button, to open up the settings. Next, make sure that the Page tab is open. Now go ahead and give your page a unique URL. I am going to change mine to Awesome Page. Once you have updated the title and changed your URL slug, you may want to click Save Draft to save your changes. And now you can click Launch Beaver Builder to begin editing the content and layout on your new awesome page. Your new page will open up as an exact copy of the original. And from here, you can begin editing with Beaver Builder. One thing to note that if you don't click Publish and leave your page instead, it will be saved as a draft. But you want to make sure that you either click Done and Save Draft, or Done and Publish to make sure that you don't risk losing any changes that you make to this page. Instead of duplicating layouts with this method, you can also save your layout as a template to use on other pages, export to other sites, and make available for clients to use in themes that you deliver to them. step-by-step instructions are available in our knowledge base, and I'll leave links to each of these individual methods in the description below.
And of course, if you got any value out of this video, be sure to hit the like button and click to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on our upcoming videos. And we'll see you in the next video.